Hello friends, welcome to the biology classes of Sanjeev Bhattacharya. Today's our topic is reproduction in organism. This chapter, reproduction in organism, is in class 12, chapter 1, which belongs to unit 1, reproduction. 14 marks questions comes from the unit 1st, reproduction, in class 12 biology paper. Subject code is 044. Now, what we have to learn in this chapter, reproduction in organism. In this chapter, we have to learn only two things. Number one, reproduction, and number second, types of reproduction. In this chapter, we have to learn the basic concepts of the reproduction. The exceptions, the definitions, the examples, and some specialties related to the topic reproduction. First of all, we will know about the reproduction. That what is reproduction? Reproduction. Reproduction is a biological process by which a living organism creates or generates a living organism of its own kind, or you can say of the same species. Now, the question arises here, why a organism reproduces? Means, what is the significance or importance of reproduction? First of all, the importance or significance of reproduction is reproduction ensures continuity of species or race. Number second, reproduction ensures transmission of genetic material from parents to offsprings. Number third, reproduction involves mutation or variation, thus plays an important role in evolution. And lastly, reproduction helps in maintaining the balance of number of different organisms in nature. This is the significance or importance of reproduction. Now, the second question arises that, what are those factors which affect the mode of reproduction in any organism? The factors which affect the mode of reproduction of any organism are mainly, number one, number of organisms participating in reproduction. You know that if single organism participates in any reproduction, it is called asexual reproduction, and if two parents are involved in reproduction, then it is called sexual reproduction. It means that number of organisms participating in reproduction is a major factor which affects the mode of reproduction in any organism. Number second, genetic makeup of the organism. Genetic makeup means either organism is haploid or diploid. Number third, organism's habitat and internal physiology. It also affects the mode of reproduction in any organism. And lastly, the climatic condition in which organism survives or in which organism lives also affects the mode of reproduction of that organism. A question was asked in CBSE board examination from this topic was, reproduction is not an essential vital process for the survival of an organism. Even then, the organism invests huge resources on this process. Why? Reproduction is not an essential vital process, but it is treated as a life process. Because, number one, reproduction is a means for the survival of the population of species. Number two, reproduction adds new individuals in a population. And number third, reproduction maintains the balance of number of organisms of a species in nature. That's why the reproduction is treated as vital process or life process or biological process or essential process. Thank you. Now, let us see the types of reproduction. Reproduction is mainly of two types. Number one, asexual reproduction, and number two, sexual reproduction. What is asexual reproduction or what is sexual reproduction? For this, we can compare it. Let us see. Asexual reproduction. A means absent, and sex is absent, means the reproduction in which sex organs are not utilized is termed as asexual reproduction. Just opposite to this, the reproduction in which sex organs are utilized is termed as sexual reproduction. Now, what are the fundamental differences between asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction? Let us see. In asexual reproduction, single parent is required, while in sexual reproduction, two parents of opposite sex are required. Two parents of opposite sex means one is male and another one is female parent. Number second, reproductive units are buds, spores, or etc. in asexual reproduction, while in sexual reproduction, reproductive units are male and female gamete. You can say sperm or ova or ovum. Number third, generally asexual reproduction occurs in lower organism. Lower organisms means unicellular organisms, just like members of protozoa, for example, amoeba, paramecium, euglena, etc. Sexual reproduction generally occurs in higher organisms, for example, mammals. Asexual reproduction generally performed by mitosis, while sexual reproduction generally performed by meiosis. Now, here the question arises, what is mitosis or what is meiosis? As you have learned in class 11, cell division, mitosis or meiosis, both are type of cell division. But the basic difference between mitosis and meiosis is, mitosis is a cell division which is performed in vegetative or somatic or meristematic cells, while meiosis is a type of cell division which is performed in sex cells via mitosis. Growth and development and asexual reproduction is performed, but via meiosis, gamete formation, you can say gametogenesis takes place, means you can say spermatogenesis, oogenesis. Mitosis is a simple process, it takes less time, but meiosis is a complex process, and in comparison to mitosis, it takes more time. By mitosis, one parent cell divides to form two daughter cells, but via meiosis, one parent cell divides to form four daughter cells. The daughter cells formed by mitosis are just equivalent to the parent cell, means similar to parent cell, but via meiosis formed daughter cells are haploid in nature, means if parent is diploid in nature, after meiosis the daughter cells are formed will be haploid in nature, means chromosome number of daughter cells becomes just half to the parent cell via meiosis. Now, asexual reproduction, gametogenesis and fertilization do not take place in asexual reproduction, but in sexual reproduction, gametogenesis and fertilization takes place. Now, the question is, what is gametogenesis and what is fertilization? Gametogenesis means formation of gametes. And fertilization, fusion of male and female gamete. As because gamete formation do not take place in asexual reproduction, so that's why fertilization also do not take place in asexual reproduction. But as because in sexual reproduction gametogenesis takes place, so male and female gametes are formed, that's why male and female gamete fuse to fertilize. Now, in asexual reproduction, it took less time, and in less time, more number of offsprings are produced. But sexual reproduction takes place more time because it is a time consuming process in which less number of offsprings are produced. And lastly, offsprings produced are genetically identical in asexual reproduction. Why? As because earlier I told you that offsprings produced in asexual reproduction are by mitosis. So that's why they are genetically identical, and that's why they are termed as clones. But in sexual reproduction, offspring produced are genetically variable. Why variation takes place? Variation takes place because sexual reproduction is performed by meiosis, and due to meiosis, the chromosome number becomes half of the parent in the daughter cell. That's why variation takes place. And as because variation takes place in sexual reproduction, it plays a vital role in evolution. Now, we will know about the types of asexual reproduction. In your NCERT book, there are 5 types of asexual reproduction. But here, more types I have increased. Let us see how many types of asexual reproduction are. Number 1, fission. Number 2, budding. Number 3, fragmentation. Number 4, sporulation. Number 5, regeneration. Number 6, parthenogenesis. Number 7, plasmatomy. Number 8, germination. And number 9, vegetative propagation. Before explanation of these types of asexual reproduction, first we have to know what are the disadvantages of asexual reproduction. As in board examination also asked that which type of reproduction is better, asexual or sexual? The answer is sexual. It means sexual reproduction is better than asexual reproduction, as because at the time of origin of life on earth, first asexual reproduction was performed by the organism, and sexual reproduction evolved from that. It shows that there are some disadvantages or demerits of asexual reproduction. Let us see what are the disadvantages of asexual reproduction. Number 1, there is no mixing of genetic material. Therefore, no variation takes place in asexual reproduction. Number 2, since variation do not occur, asexual reproduction has no role in evolution. Number 3, due to rapid multiplication, it causes overcrowding. And number 4, produced offsprings have low adaptability to the changed environment. These are the 4 major disadvantages. That's why sexual reproduction is better than asexual reproduction, especially this one. Produced offsprings by asexual reproduction have low adaptability to the changed environment. So that's why in the course of evolution, sexual reproduction is evolved from asexual reproduction. Now, before starting the explanation of types of reproduction, I want to focus one popular term from asexual reproduction, that is clone. What is clone or what are clones? Before telling you about the clone, first of all, I want to say who discovered the clone first. J.B.S. Harden was the first person who discovered the clone. Now, let us see what is clone. Organisms which are morphologically and genetically identical to their parents are termed as clone. Organisms which are morphologically and genetically identical. Is there any other definition of clone? Yes. Very simply, offsprings formed by asexual reproduction are termed as clone. Why? Because they are morphologically and genetically identical to their parents. If offsprings are morphologically and genetically identical to their parents, then they can be termed as clone. Clones are morphologically and genetically identical to their parents because clones are formed by mitosis. Mitosis, a type of cell division. Now, let us see our first topic, fission. What is fission? Fission. Fission is a type of asexual reproduction in which a parent cell divides to form two or more daughters. Fission is mainly of two types, binary fission and multiple fission. What is binary fission? Or what is multiple fission? The answer is encrypted inside its name. Binary means when by fission a parent cell equally divides to form two, bimesh two, two daughter cells or two offspring, then it is called binary fission. And if by the fission, a parent cell divides to form many daughter cells, then it is called multiple fission. Now, types of binary fission. Binary fission is mainly of three types. Number one, irregular binary fission or simple binary fission. Number two, longitudinal binary fission. And number third, transverse binary fission. Now, what are these? Simple or irregular binary fission. Binary fission in which a parent cell divides randomly at any plane to form two daughters, then it is called simple or irregular binary fission. This type of binary fission is generally observed in amoeba. Now, number second, longitudinal binary fission. Binary fission in which a parent cell divides by longitudinal division to form two daughters. It is called longitudinal binary fission. Longitudinal binary fission is generally observed in Euclina. And the third one, transverse binary fission. Transverse binary fission. Binary fission in which a parent divides by transverse division to form two daughters. It is called transverse binary fission. Transverse binary fission is observed in paramecium. Now, let us see how simple or irregular binary fission takes place in amoeba. Amoeba, this is a member of protozoa. It is the unicellular organism. In this organism, how simple or irregular binary fission takes place. In amoeba, first of all, simple or irregular binary fission takes place in favorable condition. Favorable condition means when temperature is suitable, food is available, water is available. When simple or irregular binary fission takes place in amoeba, first of all, amoeba sheds its pseudopodia. Then karyokinesis occurs in the nucleus. Karyokinesis means division of nucleus. Division of nucleus occurs in amoeba, due to which the parent nucleus divides into two equal daughter nucleus. After the completion of karyokinesis, cytokinesis starts. Cytokinesis means division of cytoplasm. As the cytokinesis completes, the parent amoeba divides to form two daughter amoeba. As because this division randomly occurs in any plane, so that's why this binary fission is known as simple or irregular binary fission. Now, let us see how longitudinal binary fission takes place in euglena. Euglena, it is a unicellular organism. It is member of protozoa. And one more important thing, it is link between plant and animal. Now, in euglena, via mitosis, longitudinal binary fission takes place. How? First of all, in euglena, karyokinesis takes place. Karyokinesis means, already told, division of nucleus. First, parent nucleus divides to form two daughter nucleus by karyokinesis. Then, after the completion of karyokinesis, cytokinesis starts. Cytokinesis means division of cytoplasm. And this division of cytoplasm occurs longitudinally. And due to this division, the parent euglena divides to form two daughter euglena. And in this way, longitudinal binary fission takes place in euglena. Now, let us see how transverse binary fission takes place in paramecium. Paramecium is member of protozoa. Paramecium is a unicellular organism. And one more important thing, paramecium is also known as flipper animalcule because due to its shape, just like a flipper. Now, during the time of transverse binary fission, as because in paramecium, two nucleus are found, one is macronucleus and one is micronucleus. Karyokinesis starts with micronucleus. As we know, karyokinesis means division of nucleus. Karyokinesis starts from micronucleus, means small nucleus. First, by karyokinesis in micronucleus, micronuclear divides into two daughter nucleus, and just after the completion of karyokinesis of micronucleus, karyokinesis of macronucleus starts. Due to karyokinesis of macronucleus, macronucleus also divides into two daughter nucleus. After the completion of karyokinesis, either it is micronucleus or it is macronucleus, means just after the formation of the daughter nucleus, cytokinesis starts. As earlier told, cytokinesis means division of cytoplasm. Just after completion of cytokinesis, the parent paramecia divides into two daughter paramecia. But here, one important thing, the two daughter paramecia formed by parent paramecia, the anterior daughter one is called proter and the posterior daughter paramecia is called opage. Now, after completion of transverse binary fission, let us see what is multiple fission. As earlier I told, multifacial fission is a type of fission in which a parent divides to form many daughters without incestment or after incestment. Plasmodium vivax, a parasite which causes malaria in human being, multiple fission is observed in Plasmodium. During the asexual cycle in human or Plasmodium vivax, multiple fission is observed. Here, in the Schwann stage, the nucleus divides to form 14 to 20 daughter nuclei. These daughter nuclei took a bit of cytoplasm and converts into merozoites. And after rupturing the wall, these merozoites get free. This is the multiple fission in Plasmodium. Before starting our second topic, I want to discuss here a question asked in board examination, that what type of organism can be considered as immortal and why? The answer is unicellular protozoans, for example amoeba. The best example is amoeba, in which a parent on maturity split into two daughter cells can be considered as immortal, because natural death does not occur in such type of organism. Now, let us discuss our second topic, budding. What is budding? Asexual reproduction by bud is called budding. And what is bud? Bud is an asexual reproductive unit which originates as an outgrowth inside or outside the parent organism, and when detached from parent, gives rise to a new individual. Budding is of two types, exogenous budding and endogenous budding. Exogenous budding, exo means outside, and endo means inside. When bud originates outside the parent body, it is called exogenous budding, and when bud originates inside the parent body, it is called endogenous budding. Now, first we will take the example of Hydra, in which exogenous budding takes place. In Hydra, exogenous budding takes place in favorable condition. In the favorable condition, in the parent Hydra, of outgrowth comes out. Maybe it is one in number, maybe it is many in number. This outgrowth give rise to the bud. This bud, after detachment from the parent, give rise to a new hydra, which is called daughter hydra. Now the second example is exogenous budding in yeast. As because both examples are given in NCERT, so I am discussing here two examples. Exogenous budding in yeast. Yeast is a fungi, unicellular fungi. In yeast, exogenous budding is observed. Yeast is a unicellular organism. In yeast, outgrowth occurs same as in hydra. After the outgrowth comes outside, a little bit cytoplasm of parent yeast moves to that outgrowth. After that, the parent nucleus divides by mitosis. Here, one controversy is present because in some books it is given that this parent nucleus divides by mitosis, and in some books it is given this parent nucleus divides by a mitosis. So whatever it is, this parent nucleus either divides by mitosis or a mitosis, two daughter nucleus are formed. After the formation of two daughter nucleus, the bud detached from the parent yeast and new yeast is formed. After exogenous budding, now we will see about the endogenous budding. Budding in which buds are formed inside the parent body is called endogenous budding. The best example for endogenous budding is spongula. In spongula, endogenous budding is observed. Now, let us see our next topic, fragmentation. What is fragmentation? Fragmentation is a type of asexual reproduction in which when a single parent breaks into many pieces and each piece or fragment gives rise to a new individual of that kind, it is called fragmentation. Generally, fragmentation occurs accidentally. It is best observed in planaria, which is an example of animal, and oscillatoria, which is example of a plant. Now, our next topic, sporulation. Sporulation. Asexual reproduction by spore is called sporulation. Now, the question arises, what is spore? Spore is a microscopic unicellular asexual reproductive structure which gives rise to a new individual. A question arises here, spore is formed in favorable condition or unfavorable condition. Both types of spores are observed. Some spores are formed in favorable condition and some spores are formed in unfavorable condition. Let us see some examples. Spores are generally observed in bacteria, algae and fungi. According to NCERT syllabus, three spores we have to focus mainly: conidia, endospore and cuspore. What is conidia? Conidia is a non-motile spore which is formed in unfavorable condition. It is generally observed in bacteria. What is endospore? Endospore is a non-motile spore which is formed under unfavorable condition. It is also observed in bacteria. And what is juice pore? Juice pore are motile spores which are formed in favorable condition. It is generally observed in algae. One question is asked in CBSE board examination that what is similarity and dissimilarity between conidia and juice pore. The similarity between conidia and juice pore is that both conidia and juice pore are asexual spores. But what is the dissimilarity? The dissimilarity between conidia and juice pore is that conidia is a non-motile spore while juice pore is a motile spore. Conidia is formed in unfavorable condition while juice pore is formed in favorable condition. Now, in the last section of sporulation, we have to learn about minimum two spores each in case of bacteria, fungi and algae. Maybe question will be asked in the board examination. Two spores formed in bacteria are conidia and endospore. Two spores formed in fungi are iridiospore and teliospore. And two spores formed in algae are juice spore and aplanospore. Now let us see our next topic, regeneration. What is regeneration? Process by which organism restores their lost body parts is called regeneration. Its best example is starfish. If arm, it is a part of body. If in an accident it cuts, it again regenerates. Another example is lizard tail. Human female, the endometrium. In the case of human female, endometrium is shed off after plus minus 3 days in 28 days menstrual cycle. Now, our next topic is plasmotomy. What is plasmotomy? A type of asexual reproduction by which a multinucleate parent divides to form many multinucleate daughter individuals but without division of nuclei. This is very important, without division of nuclei. Example, Opelina. In Opelina, plasmotomy is observed. Now the question is, what is gemmule or what is gemma? Gemmule is an asexually produced mass of cells that is capable of developing into an animal. While gemma is a cell or cluster of cells or bud-like body or leaf-like body that separates from the parent plant to form a new plant. In freshwater sponge, gemmule is observed. While in case of bryophytes, gemma is observed. Now, our next topic is parthenogenesis. What is parthenogenesis? Very famous topic. Development of a new individual from an unfertilized egg is called parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis was first observed by Bonnet in 1745. Now, let us discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of the parthenogenesis. What are the advantages of parthenogenesis? The first advantage of parthenogenesis is it avoids wastage of germ plasm in the form of sperm and Number second, advantageous mutations are transferred to offspring by parthenogenesis. Then, what are the disadvantages of parthenogenesis? Parthenogenetic species are very susceptible to changing environment due to limited capacity of adaptation against the environment. So, these are the advantages and disadvantages of the parthenogenesis. Now, let us see the types of parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis is mainly of two types, natural parthenogenesis and artificial parthenogenesis. Natural parthenogenesis means the parthenogenesis which occurs naturally. Then, what is artificial parthenogenesis? Artificial parthenogenesis, parthenogenesis which is stimulated artificially. For example, by giving low temperature means cooling, by the treatment of acids, etc. So, there are two types of parthenogenesis, natural and artificial. Now, let us discuss about the types of the natural parthenogenesis. Natural parthenogenesis is mainly of three types, arachnotrophy, theritrophy and amphitrophy. What is arachnotrophy? When by the process of parthenogenesis only males are produced, then such type of parthenogenesis is called arachnotrophy. It is generally observed in honeybee and turkey bird. What is theritrophy? Theritrophy is a type of parthenogenesis in which only females are produced. Theritrophy is generally observed in reptile lizard. And what is amphitrophy? Amphitrophy is the type of parthenogenesis in which either male or female, not fixed, either male or female is produced. Then such type of parthenogenesis is called amphitrophy. Amphitrophy is generally observed in aphids or aphid. One question was asked many times in CBSE board examination that honeybee reproduce by sexual reproduction, but both haploid and diploid organisms are observed in honeybee family. Why? They are asking about the reason. Yes, it is true that honeybee reproduces by sexual reproduction. Female gamete which develops by parthenogenesis give rise to the males or drones. They are haploid in nature. But if fertilization occurs, then zygote is developed and zygote is deployed in nature. If it is fertile in nature, then it is queen, and if it is sterile in nature, then it is worm. So this is the main reason why in a honeybee family both haploid and diploid organisms are observed. Another question in CBSE board examination is asked that what is the basic difference between parthenogenesis and parthenocarpy. The major difference between parthenogenesis and parthenocarpy is, number one, parthenogenesis. What is parthenogenesis? Development of an organism without fertilization. And parthenocarpy, development of a fruit without fertilization. The second difference is, as we know the definition, parthenogenesis is observed in animals, while parthenocarpy is observed in plants. And number third difference is, why are parthenogenesis haploid organisms, generally haploid organisms, rarely diploid, generally haploid organisms are produced. But why, apart from carbony, seedless fruits are produced. Parthenogenesis is generally reported in turkey bird, beetle, lizard, honeybee, etc. While parthenocarpy is reported in banana, grapes, etc. One more question is asked in board examination from this section, parthenogenesis, that banana is a true fruit as well as parthenocarpic fruit. How? Banana is a true fruit because it develops from ovary, and banana is a parthenocarpic fruit because it develops from unfertilized ovary. Now let us see our next topic, vegetative propagation. What is vegetative propagation? A form of reproduction in which a relatively large and equally differentiated part of a plant body becomes detached and developed into an independent plant. It is called vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is mainly of two types: natural vegetative propagation and artificial vegetative propagation. If vegetative propagation occurs naturally by plant parts, it is called natural vegetative propagation. For example, by root, by stem, by leaves, by bulbul. And if vegetative propagation is induced artificially, then it is called artificial vegetative propagation. Artificial vegetative propagation is generally of three types: first, cutting; second, layering; and third, grafting. Now we are in the last session of our chapter, sexual reproduction events. Here we have to learn only about the basics or fundamentals. For convenience, the events which take place during sexual reproduction are categorized into three categories. Number one, pre-fertilization events. Number second, fertilization. And the third and last one, post-fertilization events. Number one, pre-fertilization events means the events which takes place before fertilization. What are those events which takes place before fertilization? Number one is gametogenesis, and number second is transfer of gametes. Gametogenesis. Formation of gamete is called gametogenesis. If it is formation of sperm, it is called spermatogenesis. If it is formation of ova or ovum, it is called oogenesis. Formed gametes are haploid in nature because gametogenesis occurs through meiosis. Means gametes are formed by meiosis, so their nature is haploid. The gamete mother cell by which gametes are produced is called meiocyte. Gamete may be homogamete, may be heterogamete. If the male and female gametes are morphologically or physiologically similar in nature, then it is called homogamete. And if morphologically or physiologically dissimilar in nature, it is called heterogamete. Now, transfer of gametes. In maximum cases, it is observed that male gamete is motile in nature, while female gamete is stationary. In few cases, just like algae, both male and female gametes are motile in nature. Now, second event is fertilization. What is fertilization? Fusion of male and female gamete is called fertilization or syngamy. Fusion of nucleus of male and female gamete is called karyogamy, while fusion of cytoplasm of male and female gamete is called cytogamy. Fertilization is generally of two types: external fertilization and internal fertilization. When fertilization occurs outside the female body, it is called external fertilization. External fertilization is generally observed in frogs. While when fertilization occurs inside the female body, it is called internal fertilization. The best example of internal fertilization is human being. Internal fertilization is observed in human beings. Last question is post-fertilization events. Post-fertilization events means those events which takes place after fertilization. There are two events: formation of zygote and formation of embryo. The first question arises here: what is zygote? The resultant of fertilization means the resultant of fusion of male and female gamete is called zygote. Zygote is generally diploid in nature. While what is embryo? Embryo develops from zygote. Formation of embryo or development of embryo from zygote is called embryogenesis.
Now let us discuss about some CBSE board exam questions which were asked on speciality about flowering in different species. In this regard, first of all, we will discuss the speciality observed in Nila Kuriji or Strobilianthus kunthiana. This plant flowers once in 12 years. In India, last time it is observed in September-October 2006 in hilly areas of Kerala, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Secondly, we will discuss about the speciality observed in bamboo. Plant flowers once in lifetime after 50 to 100 years and dies. This speciality is observed in bamboo plant. Thirdly, we will discuss about the speciality observed in Mediterranean orchid, Orophyrus. Floral pattern of Mediterranean orchid guarantee cross-pollination. Mediterranean orchid bears flower which resembles the female wasp, Colpa aurea, in color, smell, as well as appearance, because it shows pollen mimicry. The male wasp mistakes them as their female counterparts. Therefore, in the process of their pseudocopulation, they pollinate the flower. Lastly, I want to discuss a question: why water hyacinth is known as terror of Bengal? Water hyacinth or Icornia plant is also known as terror of Bengal because it was first introduced in Bengal due to its beautiful flower and shape of leaves, but it proves itself as a highly invasive aquatic weed. By offset, it propagates vegetatively at a rate faster than we could remove them. It drains oxygen from the water and leads to fish mortality. As fish is supplement food of people in Bengal, and water hyacinth causes food scarcity, That's why it is known as Terror of Bengal.
Thanks for watching my video. Hope you have understand and like the content. For further updates of my upcoming videos, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you and have a good day.